Hello everyone. So in previous videos, I've given you a proper and thorough analysis of previous year UGC NET question papers, which was regarding the paper 2 and the paper 3. Now in this video, I'm going to give you a thorough analysis of UGC NET July 2018 question paper, because the pattern has changed this year. That is why it was important for us to analyze what are the changes that you have observed in 2018 question papers as compared to before. And this is only one of a kind analysis, because no one has ever done this kind of analysis for in terms of videos. So I think you will not find this kind of content anywhere else. This kind of content is only available with us, because we are creating all the content by analyzing the previous year question papers only. So this is the paper 2 analysis, which was for July 2016. As you can see, this is July 2016. August 2016 examination, June 2015, December 2015, June 2014 and December 2014. So we have taken the previous year question papers of UGC NET examination. Now in these previous year question papers, I have taken all the subjects that came in the paper 2. This is about the paper 2. And we have seen that total 6% questions came from digital logic. 15.67% question came from programming data structures and algorithm. We have 2.33% questions from theory of computation. In operating system, we got 9.66%. Architecture, we got 2.33%, and so on. So we have already given this analysis before. So you can check out this analysis in this video also. You can pause this video to get this analysis. This is a total thorough subject wise analysis, which is about what is the number of questions you got from a particular subject in the past. Now, this unique subject here, as you can see, this unique subject, it is generally a part of operating system. So generally, I've counted the unique subject separately here. But when you study operating system, now this is just a case study of the operating system. So every year we are going to expect at least one question, exactly only one question from Unix, because that is just a case study of operating systems. Okay, so this year also only one question came from Unix. Now this is the paper 3 analysis for July 2016, August 2016, June 2015, December 2015, June 2014 and December 2014. So this is the paper 3 analysis. As you can see, the percentage of questions that came from a particular subject that has changed. For example, here HTML and XML, this is actually web technology subject. So from web technology, we got 1.77% questions. Computer graphics, initially, previously we got 12% questions, 12.5%. Artificial intelligence and fuzzy logic, we got 2.22%. And we have programming languages, which is object-oriented programming, which contains C++ as well as Java. So we got 5.77% questions, and so on. So you can check this thorough analysis here. Now what has changed in 2018? So the main topic of this video is a thorough analysis of 2018 question paper, because we have only paper 2 now. We don't have paper 3. So this is a thorough analysis about the questions that came from a particular subject. Now here you can see in a discrete mathematics, I've given so many questions, but actually in discrete mathematics, I added two subjects, which is discrete mathematics plus artificial intelligence, because the proposition logic part of artificial intelligence, proposition logic and predicate logic of AI, that can be counted in discrete mathematics subject. So this discrete mathematics subject is containing some questions from AI also. Okay, now you can see from digital logic subject, the total number of questions came is around 7 questions, so which is approximately 7%, and it has not changed comparatively. There's no huge change, so it is same as before. From programming data structures and algorithm, again in the past also, see, generally what used to happen in paper 2, we used to have 50 questions, and paper 3 we used to have 75 questions, and here we have written the percentage of questions that came from a particular subject. Now you can see there's no huge change in programming data structures algorithm, it is exactly the same. Now in theory of computation, there are 9 questions that they have asked, so it is similar to the previous case also. From operating system, they have asked 9 questions. From computer architecture plus microprocessor, in total they have asked total 3 questions, because they have asked very few questions from computer architecture, which is approximately 2 questions only this time. So something like this. Now in compiler design they asked only one question. So generally compiler design is counted with theory of computation, because if you study theory of computation, they definitely are going to study compiler design. But still they only asked one question in compiler design this time. So the percentage of questions that they asked from this subject has dropped. Now in DBMS, they are asking 9 questions, so which is similar to before only. In computer networks and network security, so I have added 2 portions here, network security and computer networks. Now this network security is a part of computer networks. You can also study network security separately, but we are going to consider network security as a part of computer networks only. And they're asking a total of 8 questions, so there's no huge changes here also. In discrete mathematics, as you can see, we got 14 questions, and there's no huge changes here also, because that was totally expected. The only change that we got, that was a huge change, is that we did not got any question from data mining. So they have not asked any question from data mining this year. In software engineering, we got around 10 questions, there's no huge change. In Unix, we got 1 question, there's no huge change. Because obviously we are going to get 1 question, because it is a case study, so it is a case study of operating system. Right, so obviously we are going to get only 1 question from this. And then we have object-oriented programming. Now this OOPS programming also contains Java. So Java plus C and C++, we got 3 questions here this time, that is from Java. And then maths and linear programming, we got 2 questions, so there's no huge change as compared to before. Okay, in computer graphics we got 3 questions, so there's a huge change. The number of questions has dropped in terms of computer graphics. They only asked very few questions. So this computer graphics contain computer graphics and you can say image processing. So very few questions asked from computer graphics and image processing. In artificial intelligence, they asked 3 questions here, which is again no huge change, because we combined some portions from discrete mathematics and artificial intelligence here, which is related to predicate logic. And then from mild computing, only 2 questions is asked, which is good. And one of these questions, actually, you can compare that question from computer networks subject only. So if I roughly categorize this one, then only one question has asked from mobile computing. In web technology, they ask 2 questions, which is not a huge change. So there's only one huge change here, that they have not given any question from data mining. Otherwise, the number of questions that you are getting, that is very similar to the previous case only. Okay. Now this is just for this year analysis. From every subject I have given you what is the percentage of questions they have asked for this year. And the red ones are showing that you can leave this subject maybe, because these subject they have not asked any question from these subject, or very few questions they have asked from these subjects. And green ones are saying that you can give less emphasis to this, because I mean you can give emphasis to them, but they are asking very few questions from this, as you can see. But the black subjects, you cannot leave this subject. You cannot leave digital logic, you cannot leave programming data structures, theory of computation, operating system, DBMS, computer networks, discrete mathematics and software engineering. So these subjects came in front. So these were the major subjects which consisted, what is the percent of question paper that they are consisting? That is 7 plus 7, 14 plus 9 plus 9 plus 9 plus 8 plus 8 plus 14 plus 10. So this is total 28. Plus 10 is 38 plus 93 is 27 plus 16 plus 7, so you can count it out. So that is nearly, if you calculate this value, what will be this value, let me just calculate it, this one. So that is nearly 88%. Okay, so your 88% question paper just came from these subjects only, so you can consider these subjects as one of the major subjects only. So if let us say the cutoff percentage goes to around 55 to 60%, now you can clearly see that even if you prepare these subjects only, then you can clear the UGC NET examination just by preparing these subjects, because these are the major and most important subject for the examination. Okay, I hope that this analysis was helpful for you. And if you want to take video lectures, because we do all the thorough analysis for every year question papers, and we make our study material according to the thorough analysis also. For example, this year also I'm going to update my video lectures according to the questions that we got and according to the question papers that we got. So to make it the best material that is available online. So if you want to take classroom coaching, or if you want to take video lectures for UGC NET examination, then you can call us or WhatsApp on this number, or you can just email us on this number. Okay. So we are launching the next classroom batch for UGC NET from 5th of August. So 5th of August is an important date. You can note it down. If you want to take the classroom batch for UGC NET, then the batch will be in Delhi. That will be from 5th of August. And if you cannot attend the classroom coaching, you can take the video lectures from us. Right. So if you like the video, then please like the hit the like button as well as comment, as so that we can get more information, more insight from your comments only. Okay. And thank you so much for watching this video.